Hi, Canisius. It's Thursday, April 23rd, and I'm Alexis Book. Today, we will be sitting down with former editor-in-chief of The Griffin, Jordan LeBarwer, to discuss the recent change in public safety directors. We will also give you an inside look at UBCon, the Canisius rowing team's performance at the Black Rock Cup, as well as a special appearance by musical guest, Fanous of Maritime Law. And as always, we will give you the latest on sports this past week and upcoming events on campus. Stay tuned. This is Canisius Connections. Welcome back to Canisius Connections. I'm joined by Griffin insider Jordan LeBarwer. Hi, Jordan.
How are you?
I'm good. How are you?
I'm very good.
All right, so we're going to talk about the position change for directors of public safety at Canisius. So how does Gary Everett feel about leaving his position at Canisius?
Well, he's been here a long time, so he definitely said he feels, you know, a little bit of regrets, but not enough to keep him on the job. Mm-hmm. He said he's on call 24 hours a day. He's turning 65 years old. And he kind of knows it's time.
Yeah. All right. So as of last week, Johnson was named his replacement as director of public safety. What did it take to get him into this position?
Well, a round of interviews, very similar to what they did for the recent vice president search, where they brought in a number of candidates, had them present in front of the community, meet with different groups of people on campus. And it really was his pedigree. He's been in law enforcement in Rochester for decades, and they seem to think he was a man for the job.
All right. So what changes is Johnson planning on making in his first year at Canisius?
Well, in talking to our reporters, he seemed to emphasize meeting with people from the community more often to make sure everything's cohesive, everybody's on the same page, and build on that relationship. Admittedly, he thought that would be a process that would grow over time. Mm-hmm. But in talking to Gary Everett, too, it's going to be, he's going to have to adapt to campus policing versus, working in an actual police department, which Director Everett said was very different. So I think that'll be an adjustment, too.
Mm-hmm. All right. So it's reported that Johnson's going to start his first day on the job on May 1st, which is our quad party and arguably the rowdiest day of the year. How do you think Johnson's going to interact with students on his first day?
I would think just like Gary Everett would, he'll be there with him, and so that'll help smooth the transition, as he will for the first month. They'll be working together for an entire month. The one thing Gary Everett always stresses is it's not their job to get students in trouble, it's their job to protect students. So they'll be out there just trying to make sure everyone stays safe, everyone stays in good shape, and make sure nothing happens.
All right. And so how are Johnson and Everett planning on working together to smooth out the process exactly?
Like I said, it's just that first month. I think he's going to just show him the jobs. And like I said, making that adjustment, making sure it's not like there are some changes where, like I said, you are trying to protect students. How do you handle picking up a student in the middle of the night? Mm-hmm. Different things like that and just learning the basics.
All right. Well, thank you for having us on our show, Jordan.
Thank you for having me.
No problem. Stay tuned. When we come back, Brandon and Kia will give you the latest in sports.
Hi, I'm Jared the Subway Guy, and this is my story. Young guy eats too much junk food and gains a lot of weight. Guy changes his life by eating at Subway twice a day and walking a lot. Guy loses over 200 pounds and keeps weight off for 17 years. Guy now has two kids, and even more reason to pass on better eating habits to young people everywhere. This is my story. Ready to write yours? Subway, eat fresh.
There's four seasons in hockey. The preseason, the regular season, the first three rounds of the playoffs, and then there's the cup final. Different level altogether. It's now about a will and a way. The faces are gone, the beards grow long, and the cup is at stake. Here he is! He scores!
They get it right back in the series.
What a beautiful play! Comes in like Sorgo, shot, he scores!
Unbelievable! Look out, big hit coming.
Oh, what a stop! Did you see that? Big hit!
This isn't even fair to be this good.
And this is just a thing of beauty. Are you kidding me? How's that for showtime? Doesn't get any bigger.
Welcome back, everyone, to Canisius Connection. My name is Brandon Rudd.
And I'm Kia Gale.
And lucky for you, we're here to bring you your sports from the Kessler Corner. How are you, Kia?
I'm good, other than the fact that it snowed in April.
Oh, yeah, and definitely. Well, hopefully things will cheer up. But now let's get into some sports. Now, with baseball, the team came into their weekend series against George Mason riding a three-game win streak. However, that will quickly come to an end as George Mason opened the first game of the series with six runs in the first three innings, winning the game by a final score of 7-4. Canisius and George Mason would split the remaining two games with a set of Canisius winning 8-2 on Saturday and losing the game 8-3 on Sunday. Then the Grips made a short trip up north to University of Buffalo where they took on the UB Bulls. The Grips pounded out 15 hits and scored 16 runs, including two home runs by Brett Sadal en route to a 16-5 win. The team was supposed to play a game on Wednesday against the Akron Zips, but inclement weather postponed that game. The Grips returned to action on Saturday when they traveled to Monmouth for a three-game set against the Hawks.
Softball looked to continue their MAC dominance last weekend as they took on the Siena Saints. The Griffin came into the weekend undefeated in MAC playing, having won their first eight games against conference opponents. Second in the MAC despite losses, and they seem poised to get back in and win the column as they take on the worst team in the MAC, St. Peter's, on Saturday before squaring off against the Manhattan Jaspers on Sunday and the Niagara Purple Eagles on Wednesday.
Sounds very exciting. Now, the Roto team completed their only home event of the spring season this past Saturday. The team defeated Stetson Women's Varsity 8, Second Varsity 8, Varsity 4, and Men's 8.
Now on to women's lacrosse. The women's lacrosse team extended their win streak to a program record 10 games with a win over Monmouth on Saturday afternoon. With the win, the team clinched the MAC regular season title for just the second time in the program history. The win means that Canisius will now host the semifinals and finals of the MAC tournament on May 1st and May 3rd. Goalkeeper Kayla Scully also tied a programming record as she scored her 36th win in the net. The Griffs have one final regular season matchup against Binghamton before they get to the MAC tournament, as they look for their record-setting fifth straight MAC championship.
Well, I hope they get all the luck.
Me too.
Well, men's lacrosse is also in action last weekend as they took on Virginia Military Institute. The Griffs dominated the winless cadets from the get-go, scoring six goals in the game's first 9 minutes. Canisius held a 15-1 lead in the half, and each team would tack on five goals in the second half as Canisius took the game 20-6. The win was the largest win by Canisius in nearly 14 years when they beat Siena Saints 21-4 back in April of 2001. The Griffs season will be on the line in their final game of the season as they take on the Detroit Titans in Detroit. The Griffs need to win that game by two or more goals in order to clinch a spot in the MAC tournament for the second straight season.
Well, that's all we have for sports this week. Stay tuned because when we come back, we'll have a special musical performance by my good friend Fanus of Maritime Law.
Your feelings on winning this cup?
It's real hard to explain.
Yeah. It's...
Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome Fanous of Maritime Law.
Let's find ourselves lost for hours until we find ourselves a drink. Let's talk that sun in setting. Just need the sound of your voice. I need that coming and the comfort. Something to drown out the noise. I don't mind if we take our time, 'cause I'm all yours if you're all mine. Something I've been meaning to tell you about 3 years and a day. I'd very much like to get married, maybe have kids and move away. 'Cause there ain't nothing like your smile, those legs and those eyes. And I would beg and steal and borrow you saved my whole life. And I don't mind if we take our time, 'cause I'm all yours if you're all mine.
And this next song is a song called Permanence by my band Maritime Law.
And lately I've been sitting home, and lately I've been spending nights alone. I fill my head with thoughts, made up things like memories of that of me and you. And I'll wait here and see what there's left for me. And I'll just bite my tongue. There's one thing that I've learned, is that permanence is nothing but a made-up word. And I'll just bite my tongue. There's one thing that I've learned, is that permanence is nothing but a made-up word. Brought me growth. These nights alone will keep me strong. So what can I say? You mean nothing to me. It's time that I just walked away. And now we're here and what there's left for me. And I'll just bite my tongue. There's one thing that I've learned, is that permanence is nothing but made up word. And I'll just bite my tongue. There's one thing that I've learned, is that permanence is nothing but made up word. Just by my tongue.
Thank you.
And there's four seasons in hockey. The preseason, the regular season, the first three rounds of the playoffs, and then there's the cup final. Different level altogether. It's now about a will and a way. The faces are gone, the beards grow long, and the cup is at stake. Here he is! He scores!
They get it right back in the series.
What a beautiful play! Comes in, high score, goes shot, he scores!
Unbelievable! Look out, a big hit coming.
Oh, what a stop! Did you see that? Big hit!
Big hit by Natsu.
He scores!
This isn't even fair to be this good.
Hi, Canisius. I'm back with Fanous from Maritime Law. Hi, Fanous.
Hi, how are you? Thanks for having me.
I'm good. Thanks for coming on the show. So why don't you tell us a little bit about your band, Maritime Law?
So basically, my band, Maritime Law, we're a five-piece pop-punk band from Buffalo, New York. And we started as just kind of a joke. Like, we've been a band for years and years and years, but we've never done anything about it. But around last year, we decided to like start writing, and we finally found a drummer, which was huge for us. And we just started playing shows around the area and recorded an EP. We've just recently coming off a break right now. We had a lineup change. We moved our drummer, Nick. He's playing guitar for us. We got a new drummer. But yeah, we're back. We're playing Battle of the Bands on Saturday at Canisius College.
It's very cool. So what other bands do you guys find inspiration from?
I mean, it's hard because there isn't really like a band that like does the same stuff as us. And like I know that sounds like cheesy and everyone would say that. But we're a pop punk band, so we just like to play like fun, upbeat punk music. But we also like sometimes like dabble in the more like hardcore stuff. So I guess like we've been compared to like A Day to Remember, but sometimes we go a little bit heavier, sometimes we're a lot lighter. As I'm sure you guys will see on Saturday, we sometimes play acoustic songs too. So we run the gamut of like different musical styles. But I just classify us as just like an upbeat band. Like we like people moving, we like people moshing and jumping, that sort of stuff.
Definitely fun. Mm-hmm. So what started you off in music?
Well, I was playing piano since I was like 4 or 5, I think. And that's a great like instrument to start learning. Mm-hmm. Because like it helps you like read music. Like a lot of the fundamentals and like basics of music are really easy to grasp on piano. And I mean every kid wants to be a rock star, I think, at some point. So I picked up a guitar and I took lessons for a little bit, but then I taught myself. And then I don't know, I've just always been into the music scene, always been going to shows, a lot of friends in bands, so decided to start one of my own.
Mm-hmm. Do you plan on doing any performances outside of the college or on the Buffalo area?
Oh, yeah. Well, since this is like our return show, it's kind of like low-key, but we play at the Waiting Room, we play at the Forum, we play sometimes horribly at Broadway Joe's. It's not our favorite place to play. There are rats under the stage. Don't
That's
go
lovely.
There. Never go see us there. But yeah, we play at a lot of the venues, and now that we have an EP recorded, we're looking into like playing in like maybe Rochester, Syracuse, even Albany, like over the summer, but we'll see. We all have busy schedules. We're all, most of us are in college. So. Mm-hmm.
It's very cool. So what's your favorite song to play on set?
You know, I don't know. I'm kind of a sucker for like the heavy music. So we have a song called Last Time I Promise, which we may or may not be playing on Saturday. And it's fast and it's aggressive and you get to like jump around and stuff. But I don't know, that's kind of toss up. I mean, I think that's like indicative of anyone who's in a band. Like, I hate all of our songs. Like, I hate them so much. And it's just because, like, you sit in a basement and you practice them over and over and over again. So usually, I guess, I have the most fun when we do a cover because it's, like, a song I like, and then, like, we don't beat it into our heads, I guess, but yeah.
Okay, quickly, last question.
Last question, okay.
Favorite lyric, not only from your band, but, like, any band?
Oh, man. That's a tough one. And it's weird because a lot of the favorite lyrics from my band is stuff we've thrown in as, like, jokes, like, during the recording process. Mm-hmm. So they're not in any of our songs, but I guess Let the Puppies Roll would have to be. And Nick, I hope you see this. I don't know how you would, but I'm speaking directly to you. I'm going to show you this, so you're going to see this. Yeah, that's just something that our wonderful drummer, and who did a lot of the recording for us and our EP, like, he would kind of add in to, like, all songs. But they're not in any of the final versions, so no one will ever. Hear that.
Yeah. All right, well, thank you so much for having us on the show. Yeah, of course.
Hi, I'm Jared the Subway Guy, and this is my story. Young guy eats too much junk food and gains a lot of weight. Guy changes his life by eating at Subway twice a day and walking a lot. Guy loses over 200 pounds and keeps weight off for 17 years. Guy now has two kids and even more reason to pass on better eating habits to young people everywhere. This is my story. Ready to write yours? Subway, eat fresh.
That's all we have for you today. We are a new show every Thursday at 6 p.m. on YouTube, Facebook, and on Channel 4.1. Thanks for tuning in, and have a great weekend, Canisius.